Hello again, art classes. I hope you're doing fantastically well. Today I want to talk to you about the idea of a flipped classroom. That is a classroom where you watch the lecture notes rather than me doing lecture in class. So when you come in, we can actually digest and play around with the information. We can actually have some fun. We can use that information to make art, to make short videos, to have major end discussions, to design a museum exhibition, and where else to actually better to have that conversation than today that I come from you from Leonardo da Vinci's studio at Christmas time. Maybe the smartest man that humanity has ever created. If not, he's definitely in the top five with his understanding of science and technology and art and culture and religion and politics and government and theater. Just a brilliant man. We want to take those ideas and incorporate them into the flipped classroom. Now, the flipped classroom model basically means that you have to take a very active role in your own education, which means you have to commit that you are going to do the work before you ever come to class, specifically working on those lecture videos and the videos to take notes. Specifically, remember, we talked about the four buckets of information, the most important one being the graded one that I'm going to be looking at and that we'll base our class conversations on, which will really be, why did the artist make this artwork or make this film? What's new and innovative, and how does it impact the world today? So what are those features? So we can have kind of really high-end conversation. From all sorts of different pedagogical researches I'll show you here, this is Edgar Dale's Code of Experience. The more we actually get you to engage with information and have those high-end, high-order thinking thoughts, the more you will learn it. So in a traditional classroom, if you professor asks you or teacher asks you to go out and read something, generally you only remember about 10% of what you read the next day, right? It goes in one out ear, it comes out. It doesn't necessarily connect with the information that you already know. We're not actually building upon frameworks. That's what we're going to do in this classroom. So at the end of this classroom, we're actually going to flip Edgar Dale's Code of Experience on its head because the class is designed that way. So you remember 10% of what they read, 20% of what you hear, 30% of what you see, 50% of what they see and hear, 70% of what they say and write, and 90% of what they do. This is what we're going to do. In a flipped classroom, it's the doing part of class that actually is the most important. Because I'm expecting that you'll come in and you'll have at least a basic understanding of the vocabulary, of the concepts, of the artworks. Then we're going to be applying them, right? Mona Lisa is one of the great artworks of all time, and the book will tell you that. The question we have to ask is when we're there, how? How do we critically evaluate the Mona Lisa versus any other artwork or any other portrait or any other, you know, yearbook portrait, even of you? How do we actually play those things out? Is she a standard of beauty? And if she is, how did we ever get that standard of beauty? Because by today's standards, we would look at her and would say, she's not particularly one of our supermodels that shows up. So what does that mean about how society has changed over time? That's largely how we're going to do it. So we're going to flip this classroom model. And the other thing we're going to do is that there's this idea called the curve of forgetting. It basically says the first time you see something, you remember a fair amount of it, particularly if it's interesting, but then the curve collapses on us within the process. Special effect brought to you by Frasier. So the second time we see it, that's the in-class lecture. We'll be reading and screening and seeing in-class lecture. So the time I see you, we are already starting off third. So here's the first, know how fast we're going to drop off here, right? First one drops off very fast. Second one drops off very fast. Third one drops off. We're going to start off class here, right? You've seen it. You've written about it. Now we talk to Frasier and we actually talk about how it relates to you. And then we're going to do a review. Then we're going to have a follow-up the next class. Then you're going to have a quiz. So by the time we get to the midterm is really pretty easy and pretty consistent, same way with the final exam. They're not terrible. And that's because you've done the work beforehand. But that is the key. In a flipped classroom model, you have to be willing to do that hour or hour and a half work of class before you are in that we would normally do in class, outside of class, so we can have high order conversations. If you are not willing to do this, think about taking art history either with someone else on a different campus, unfortunately at Kendall, I'm the only one who teaches it, or alternatively, take it at a time period when you actually developed a little bit better or have a looser schedule that allows you to actually play around a little bit with your time management to make sure that you can actually spend 3 to 4 hours a week outside of class working on this class. For my art majors, I guarantee you two things. Number one, I will work as hard as you do to actually make sure you understand the information. No one fails a Frasier art history class or a student appreciation class because they don't understand the information. There's only two people who end up not failing, because I will work my butt off to help you if you're not understanding or something. Number one, those people who can't do time management. You just have poor time management and you don't get around to doing the work, and that plummets your grade. The other one are those individuals that are just so busy. You know, I've had people do really well in my class, but they were also full-time mom or full-time parent. They had a full-time job and a full-time schedule. To those people, I applaud you. That's a remarkable kind of time management feat. But generally, it's those two people. It's people who basically can't figure out their time, either because they're way too busy or they just can't figure it out. Video games, Facebook, internet, Instagram, video, Netflix, it's got a hold on you. Otherwise, everyone else basically does really well in the class because you are rewarded for doing the work. Here's the key. In a flipped classroom, we want to reward you for doing the work beforehand so that we can actually work on high order concepts. So 30% of your grade, remember that, one third of your grade is based upon you doing the homework before you come to class. And so you got to get that in the model that I'm going to do well. Now for my art majors, this is fantastic because I guarantee you, personal guarantee of Fraser, I guarantee that you will learn the material by the end of the semester if you do the work beforehand, because I will work like the Dickens, both in and outside of class, and give you enough opportunities to play around with the information to make it valuable for you. That's when we learn. When information becomes valuable to us and how we see the world, that's how we're going to actually play around with our arts. So, and I really do want it to feel a little bit more like play and discussion than, oh, I gotta go to class. Class should be fun. We'll be doing some painting. We'll be doing some drawing. We'll be playing around with all individual artworks that we'll bring in, and there'll be a lot of discussion. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day. Bye.